Welcome, Bout Betters. I was about to exit my lane and create some content in response to Jesse on Fire's views on Diego Sanchez with bloody elbow. I just don't have the time, will, and patience for debate any longer. Despite what my views are, I just can't deal with reactionary and hypocritical people, especially whose lives and content is so drama-filled. The grift and the gift of gab is strong with that one, but the hypocrisy of the guy coming at media sources while he himself makes money off of both Diego Sanchez and his illness is a straight scumbag move. Fuck that dude, man. I think he should publicly apologize to Diego and send him some money. Since you've made it this far, please like, comment, and subscribe. Back to my crappy content. As I've always mentioned, we are always looking to fade favorites or fighters whose win conditions and skills are not favorable compared to their opponent's skills. I'm not impressed with 17-5 Jake Matthews. He's going up against Jeremiah Wells, who is 35-9-2 outside of the UFC and 1-0 in the UFC. He had that bout with Wearley Alvarez that was very exciting. He's another fighter, and I think this is another matchup similar to the Chris Curtis, Brandon Allen matchup, when we know little about Chris Curtis and Jeremiah Wells. From his one bout against Wearley Alvarez, we saw that Wells is an explosive man who really destroyed Alves in his debut, but made some problems in there. There were definitely holes in the game. He was a big underdog in his debut in that. So why am I interested in Wells? I'm not completely sold on Jake Matthews wrestling, and we don't know much about Wells counter-wrestling. We didn't really get to see a ton of his work. He was great in the clinch, and he was super strong. He controlled Alves, really well, and he was able to dictate the pace of that fight. But I don't like how Wells expends his energy, and Wells is not spectacular in his offensive or defensive striking. I also didn't like that Alves not only almost got a submission off of Wells, but that Wells had no genuine fight game plan. Wells is just a brawler, and against Matthews, that's not going to work, as Matthews has excellent striking defense at 61%. Wells also has a 71% striking defense at range. I can't fade Matthews in this, and he may be a parlay piece for me. Matthews has gone three rounds with Brady, Diego Sanchez, Emil Meek, Li Jingjiang, but he's also been knocked out by Kevin Lee and submitted three times, one of those times to James Vick, which is not a good look. I don't think Wells has a submission game, but we know that Jake Matthews has a good submission game. He has 22 takedowns in the UFC with 7 submissions, but I'm going to lean slightly on Matthews by decision just because he is a defensive fighter. But Jeremiah Wells, this is going to be in the apex, is very aggressive. So he might force Jake Matthews to take him down and Matthews to get that submission. So like Curtis, if you're on the Wells side, I think his win condition is TKO, where Matthews could get a sub or it could go to a decision. I'm leaning on that decision. What are you guys doing with this particular matchup? Will you put Matthews in a parlay? He's at -190. Yes, you could take him on the money line. What do you guys think about Wells? Please hit the comment section, like, and subscribe. As always, to anyone that has made it this far, thank you very much. Good luck this weekend if you're betting on any of the boxing, and good luck next week.